1987, young Nova Castrian Nick Wood did the impossible. At just 16, Nick, then referred to the world over as Nicky, defeated a legendary field of stalwarts to claim the most prized possession in surfing, a Rip Curl Bells Beach trophy. Nick had been touted as the next best thing since he was 11 years old, riding single fin McCoys and winning the open divisions of the Merriweather board riders. It was obvious he had the gift. At Bells in 1987, that gift was on display for all to see. Seemingly at one with the ocean, Nick moved past big name surfers one by one, his frontside wraps and new age flair devastating in the slightly onshore conditions, especially on the final day. But it was early in the event he defeated world champion Tom Curran, sending a shockwave through the sporting world. The media flocked, it was world news, and like Justin Bieber in a wetsuit, they all wanted a piece. But Nick didn't buy into it. Riding a 5'7 Gunteron with six deep channels running through it, Nick moved into the final, his closest scrap being a split decision with the clinical doctor of backhand surfing, Barton Lynch. Amazingly, another youngster, goofy-footer Richard Dog Marsh from Cronulla, also made it to the final. Nicky and Dog in Bell's final, writes track scribe John Regalis. No offence to either surfer, but this is a letdown. Perhaps it was just a sign of the times. There was little support for young guys like Nicky and Dog, rightly or wrongly. You had to fight your way to the top if you wanted to succeed. It was the law of the jungle. The cream would either rise to the top or whittle away and die. But it was Nick's day, and the man who would be king delighted the cliff tops, and despite having no tips from his godfather and former Bells champion Emma on how to surf Bells, ripped the place apart. See, unknown to the media, lapping up his Cinderella story with gusto, Nick had been to Bell six times already, and as he told Trax recently, he had his feet well and truly in. His piece de resistance, a giant lip-lined coping ride on a crunching four-foot shore break. He rode it for a mile before free-falling backwards towards the flats. Amazingly, he nailed it with an effortless ease that defied the exploding plumes of heavy Bell's Beach water around him. Head down, fist in the air, Nick saluted the sky triumphantly. Ironically, on the podium later, he was sprayed with champagne, and no one stopped to think that he was just 16 and in fact a minor. Nicky Wood, though, he'd done it. He'd beaten the best by being the best, and 87 goes down as another historic event.